Not just us state lawmakers holding a hearing at the state capitol this morning wondering why these projects have yet to be green-lighted. Today, we wanted to know what is the consequence of this apparent delay and could this cost the state money.
Emergency sprinkler repairs at the University of Colorado, air conditioning at the mental health hospital in Fort Logan, flooding prevention for the Colorado National Guard in Watkins, all projects first approved in 2017 that could have started July 1st, not happening now until late September or even next year. In fact, over $115+ million in state projects are not starting as soon as they could. Tonight, the problem solvers asking why and will a delay cost taxpayers money.
I feel like there was a delay.
Today, state lawmakers asking those very same questions. Democrats at a Capitol hearing putting blame on the state treasurer's office in Walker Stapleton. Representative Chris Hansen saying the treasurer's office had over a year to get the paperwork lined up.
Having basically a three-month delay means that you've got two major financial impacts. One, interest rates are going up, probably looking at maybe a quarter point or more impact by this delay.
And so what does that mean?
So that adds up to tens of millions of dollars.
Tonight, the treasurer's office denying there will be any financial impact.
We will meet that deadline with ample time to spare.
With officials telling the committee July 1st wasn't a deadline, but just the first day they could act and didn't because of initial concerns of a pending lawsuit facing the state.
I think that that's a perfect example of why people lose faith in government, fabricated political stunts by the Democrats.
Stapleton, who is running for governor as a Republican, has called this a political attack. Democratic lawmakers tonight disagree.
This is absolutely not politics. It is now past the middle of 2018, and we're still sitting here waiting for these programs to be funded.
Of course, it's an election year, so everything has a little bit of politics. In terms of impact, they are wide and varied. For instance, Pueblo Community College needs a bigger building for welding because there is a wait list for welders, the project impacting those students who want to enroll. On our website, we have a complete list of all projects impacted. We'll follow up, let you know when and if these projects are green-lighted in September. Joe St. George, Fox 31.
All right, Joe, thanks. Well, coming up.